It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Wright family. Greg, Karen, Tim, Janice, and Corliss, ready for action. And the Ball family. Dick, Margot, Randy, John, and Cindy. On your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the start of Family Feud, Richard Dursley.
How are you, sir? Nice to see you. Hello, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Listen, just have the nicest and safest holidays and know that we all love you, no matter what religion or faith that you have. Try and live up to it, you know. If we did that, I think we could make it a very special place, okay? Champs are right here. How are you?
All right, Richard, you said.
How much did you win, sir?
$926.
And you're the champs, and I'm proud of you. Let's meet everybody, please.
Thank you. Richard, this is my sister, Karen.
Hello, my love.
Hello, Richard.
My brother, Tim.
Hello, oh, Tim.
My sister, Janice.
Hello, Richard.
Hi, sweetie pie.
And the baby of the family, Corliss.
Hi, Cole.
Hi, Richard. Woo-hoo!
Have you gotten all your Christmas shopping done? Now, I have to tell you, we're a couple of weeks before Christmas as we taped this show, but have you?
No.
This year, I'm just not giving anything. And so I'm legally done. The Balls are here to challenge you. Good to see you.
Awesome. Thank you.
Who you got here, sir?
I have my family, my wife, Margot.
Hello, Margot.
My son, Randy.
Randy.
My other son, John, and my daughter, Cindy.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Cindy. Now, I'm a little worried here, Dick. Cindy was the only one who actually spoke to me. Margot smiled, Randy and John did. They never even said hello.
They're
hello,
usually Richard. More noisy.
Are they?
Yeah.
All right. How are you, honey?
Just fine. Thank
well,
you, Richard.
You are. Randy?
Pretty good. How you doing?
Can't complain, except the fact that you didn't talk to me. John.
I'm just doing fine. How you doing, Richard?
Remind your Jim Neighbors impressions. Just doing fine. What do you do, Dick?
I'm trying to start a new bank.
Oh, are you really?
That's right.
How does one go about starting a new bank?
Well, you have to try to find some people that will invest in your bank. We hope to open
now, have you had experience in banking?
About 26 years.
As a manager?
All the way from a bookkeeper to a manager to...
Yeah.
All the way.
Have a guy come in and want the loot with the...
Absolutely. Took me hostage.
Were you in Dog Day Afternoon?
I don't think so.
Oh, well, do you remember that? They took the bank manager. Did you really get taken, huh? How long ago?
It's been about 4 years ago.
Here in town?
In L.A., right. Downtown Los Angeles.
Tell me what happened very quickly. I mean,
very quickly, a guy came in and said he wanted to have some money. I went to one of the loan officers first. He couldn't help him, so they shifted him over to me.
Oh,
nice guy, right?
Yeah, yeah. I'd like that loan officer's name.
He kept the manager and the officer, the loan officer, hostage while he made me go back into the back and get the cash. And while I was back there, I tipped off our security people.
Is it?
Yeah. And
but that was quietly, silently?
Silently,
yeah. Yeah.
There was a security meeting going on in the bank that day, and they had about five.
Probably my brother did this job. That's the sort of timing he'd have, yeah. Stick up the chief of police convention, you know. So what happened?
We had about five security guards in the bank that day, and while he was escorting us out of the building, they tackled him and knocked him down the stairs, and the gun went rolling down the stairs. And it was kind of exciting for a while.
Well, I'm glad you're right.
But it turned out very well. They even put him in jail.
Oh, well, that's unusual.
Yeah, that's unusual. That's right.
Yeah, usually make him Father of the Year for about a year. Anyway, we're glad. Hope you'll be lucky here today. Okay?
Thank you very
Ready?
Much.
Come, let's play the feud. Let's go. People survey. Top 7 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. named Something Families Do on Christmas Eve. Yes, sir.
Sing Christmas carols.
They sing carols.
All right.
Yes, sir. Two answers will be the judge.
Celebrate.
They celebrate. Okay, you got control. What are you going to do, sir?
We're going to play, Richard.
All right, we're going to play. La-da-dee, la-da-da.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Something families do on Christmas Eve, Margaret.
I would think that somebody might open a present.
All right, good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Open a present. How are you doing there, Chef? What would you say?
How about go to a Christmas Eve mass or service?
Okay, yeah. Go to a religious service. Yes, sir. John?
How about a Christmas Eve dinner?
Have a dinner. No, not there. Okay. There's Cindy who talked to me.
Hi.
How are you, darling?
Fine.
Nice to see you.
How about go Christmas caroling?
Hey, good answer, good answer.
Sing carols.
Oh.
Well, it's all right. It's a good idea.
It's an eat. Oh, shoot.
Something the families do on Christmas Eve.
Sit around a fire.
Okay.
Good answer.
They sit around the fire. No. Dick, what would you say, sir?
I think I'm going to go with visit relatives.
Uh-huh. All right. Yes, they're okay, sir. If not, third strike, relative time. You got it. Well done.
You might like the Christmas tree.
Okay. All right. If they're down, all right. If not, third strike, they light the tree. Good. Ready.
How about stay up and wait for Santa?
If it's there, you got it all, and if not, third strike. Stay up late and wait for Santa. No! $94 up there, right?
All right. They bake.
Well,
Richard and a lot of families bake.
They bake. Sure they do. All right. If that's there, you get the money, and if not, the bank dick gets it. Bake! You got it? Seven. They wrap gifts. Yeah. Now, a lot of very mean people change religions on them. We'll be back right after this.
This week in game show history, Robert Q. Lewis first sits in for appendectomy patient and panelist Fred Allen. Then a healed Fred returns as mystery guest. And just 1 week later, Lewis plays mystery guest, fooling Fred and the panel.
94, nothing yet. Come on, pretty Karen. How 100 people surveyed, top seven answers on the board. Here's the question. I kind of like this one. Name something you would buy for your pet bird for Christmas. Yeah.
Some seeds.
Yeah. Two answers will beat that. What would you buy for your pet bird for Christmas?
A bird bath.
Aha, a bird bath. No.
Okay.
I bought my, a jacuzzi last year. Drowned. Never do that. I'll see you in a minute. Yeah, I turned on the blowers and went... Not seen a little thing since. Well, I didn't know they weren't waterproof. What would you buy your pet bird for Christmas, Randy?
How about a new cage?
Yeah. Oh, nice cage.
All right.
Okay. John?
A beak sharpener?
A beak sharpener. Oh, yeah. That's what it's called. Very good.
How about a plastic bird?
Another bird, yeah. Yeah.
Good answer.
And my bird had another bird, a plastic bird, but my bird now, of course, is with the jacuzzi people. The plastic bird is fine, and I don't have to buy him any of this rubbish at Christmas. Because I tell him it's another date. He doesn't know. She says, what is it? I said, August the 9th, a long time before Christmas. Just another bird, the plastic one. Well, honey, I just don't know why they're laughing. That was a good answer. You're going to buy something for your pet bird for Christmas?
I'm going to get him a mirror.
There's another good one. A mirror. That's what we call a Robert Goulet gift.
That's right.
A mirror. That idea was invented by people who could not afford a plastic bird. Because it looks in there and thinks it's another bird.
I'm going to buy him a bell.
They love bells.
Good answer. Good answer.
Bell. Yeah. Yeah, but they never pick them up and play them, do they? I don't know why that is.
How about, instead of a plastic bird, a real bird to keep it company?
All right.
Good answer, Randy. Good answer.
Maybe a vulture. Maybe something like that. Maybe. A hawk. A falcon for your canary. Another bird, but a real one this time.
Get your bird a little swing, a swinger.
Swing.
Right. Good answer.
Birds don't ask for much, do they? The little swings there, you got it, if not second strike. El Swingo. You're really daring, you buy him a cat. That's a pacifist. Yeah. We'll be back. $194? Nothing. Let's go! How are you doing? Okay. 100 people surveyed, top 6 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name one of Santa's reindeer. Yeah.
Rudolph.
Rudolph.
We're going to play, Richard.
We're going to play. Very good. Santa's reindeer, one of them, John, played.
You got Dancer.
Pardon?
All right.
Dancer.
Dancer. He swore at me for a second. Dancer! Yeah!
How about Dixon?
Yeah! Dixon! Oh. What was wrong? Dick, what would you say?
I'm going to have to go with Prancer.
Prancer, you got it. One Prancer to go, please. Yeah!
How about Donner?
Another good one, yeah! The ones I believe said pass, did he not? Donner!
How about Comet?
Yeah.
Get in, baby!
Comet! No. Oh. Legally changed his name to Ajax and moved on, I believe.
Vixen?
Let's take a look.
All right.
Vixen! $84 up there. Look at that. Isn't that sweet? They're doing their Christmas shopping now. Come.
Come on, Cupid.
Listen.
Cupid.
Listen.
Two answers Cupid. Up there. I need one of them.
Cupid.
Blitzen.
Oh, I love Blitzen, don't you? Blitzen's there. You get the $84. If not, a big, big lead. Blitzen. Four. That's all. $194, $84. Let's go. Come on. How are you today?
Fine, and you?
Well, I can't complain, darling. Dollar values have doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a food people hang on Christmas trees.
Yeah. Candy cane.
Candy cane.
Good answer.
You're a good player, young man. What would you say?
Popcorn.
Popcorn.
Good answer.
Yeah. Play a pass.
Play, Richard.
Play, champ. Well done. Didn't see you today.
You didn't.
How are you? Food on a Christmas tree. Hang it. What?
Cookies.
Cookie.
All right. All right.
I love cookies. Cookie. Yeah. Well, sir.
Bagels.
Right. Yeah. Good answer. Good answer.
Boy, are you in the wrong church. Happy Hanukkah, perhaps, but not. Maybe a bagel, please. As my grandmother would say, good night. Food people hang on Christmas trees. Remember, bagels have been taken by all of my people.
Nuts!
Ha! Oh, very good, very good.
Good answer.
All right. Nuts! No. Come on, Tim.
Oh, come on.
Salami.
It's Hebrew National. Well, if we got salami, you're okay. If not, get ready. Salami, please. Now, 186, give me the right answer, you'll be the champ. What do you say?
What do you say? No, what do I say?
Yeah, give me.
I'm going to say cranberries.
All right, I'm in shock here with the bagels and salami. Cranberries there, Dick, you're the champs. If not, you get to 186, the game goes on. Cranberry! No way to treat a person. Hope you had a nice time.
Thank you.
Happy, happy holidays.
Thank you. Same to you.
Thank you. You're good. You're lucky. Thank you.
I'm back with Ron. All right.
Love you. I'll play. Happy holidays. Whole play. One, two. First. Got Randy and Dick. They're going for the money. Right after we watch that. Good one.
Thanks, Ron.
Daytime is playtime with our most popular shows.
Every day you must watch.
Today, starting at noon Eastern, only on Buzzr. This is.
We wish you luck, okay?
Thanks.
All righty, 15 seconds. Name the hour when parents finally get to bed on Christmas Eve.
12 o'clock.
A color that goes with blue.
Red.
A shape chocolates come in at Christmas time.
Candy cane.
A kind of bean.
Green bean.
Well, it's Christmas Eve. National credit card.
American Express.
Turn around. You said thanks to me. Any person, when I ask for a shape of a chocolate, says candy cane. I know I've got to help this man through life. He's trying to get a new bank together, for goodness sake. Just make sure none of the investors see this particular show. Yeah. Name the hour parents finally get to bed on Christmas Eve. You said midnight. Survey said. Very nice. Color goes to blue. Red. Okay. There you go. The shape of chocolates come in at Christmas time. They come in the shape of candy cane. Survey. Ah. Kind of bean. Spring survey. National credit card. You said, don't leave home. Survey said. Now, that could be the difference between that and the big money. Stand next to your pretty lady. We are looking for Randy. Come on, Edgar. Please remind everyone, the answers Dick gave us, 20 seconds on the clock. We wish you luck. Name the hour when parents finally get to bed on Christmas Eve.
12 o'clock.
Try again.
1 o'clock.
A color that goes with blue.
Pass.
shaped chocolates come in at Christmas time?
Wreaths.
A kind of bean.
Jelly bean.
A national credit card.
Visa.
Color that goes with blue.
Aquamarine.
Turn around. You know, I believe in goodwill to all people, but this is ridiculous. I had trouble with your dad with the chocolate question. Yeah, when parents finally get to bed on Christmas Eve. Midnight and 2 a.m. tied for the top. You said 1 a.m. Everybody said. There you go. Color that goes with blue. Aquamarine. All we need is a few good men. It's a waterlogged marine joke. Survey said. Okay. This, the color that actually goes with blue, number one, is kind of, it's a toughie. It's white. Which they say is becoming quite popular. A shape that chocolates come in at Christmas time. The shape of Santa Claus was number one. You said a wreath. Survey said. Seven. Kind of bean, string bean or green bean, number one. You said a jelly bean. Survey said. Five. National credit card, you said? Visa, it was number one. We need 53 points for the money. Survey said. $5 every point, total of? There's $9.85, and we will return it. Come on.
Are you?
Bless you. Each and every day.
Some departing contestants receive the candy dish and O. Henry candy bars. Delicious peanuts and chewy caramel covered with melting fudge. O. Henry, oh so delicious. Infants and children's wear from Spencer's. A name that has meant quality and value to mothers for over 50 years. Roffler Family Hair Centers are located throughout the nation. For great hair products for the entire family, look for the Roffler sign today. A towel set and Capri foaming bath oil surrounds you with fragrant bubbles as it softens your skin all over. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.